All right, so today we are live again for our Get to Know Us session. We have somebody really special that we want you to get to know today. However, we want you to take a few moments and invite other people. So please do invite others to get on with us, share this live stream. We are a few minutes late, yes, but we got somebody really special today that we're going to talk to, and we want everybody to hear what she has to say. So if you'll take a few moments and invite others to join us, then we're going to find out a little bit more about our individual who is featured today on our Get to Know Us. Once again, if you'll go to the bottom, if you'll hit share, maybe even do a watch party. Y'all do a watch party for today. Do a watch party. Then you will help us to help other people to get to know Deacon Ronnie Bullock. So today, we're going to get to know a little bit about Deacon Ronnie Bullock. I'm excited because Deacon Ronnie Bullock has been a deacon for a while at ELC. And we want you, once again, to get to know all of the leaders at Empowerment Liberation Cathedral, better known as ELC. And so she's been a deacon for a while. She's also served as the bishop's armor bearer. And she is just a great individual. I believe you're going to hear some things that you have not heard today about Deacon Ronnie Bullock. And so that's why we have her on, so you can find out some more information about her and even some little tidbits that you never probably thought that she knew about or experienced in her life. So let's get started. Deacon Ronnie, tell us about your everyday job. How do other people know you? As I've said, a lot of times people, when they know you on your jobs, they may not know that you serve as a deacon in your church. They may not even know that you go to church. And so, you know, we want to know how the other people know you. If you want to tell where you work, that's fine. But tell us what you do every day.
Well, first, I want to say thank you, Bishop, for having me on to get to know our ELC leaders. So I appreciate you for coming up with this idea. I thought it was a fantastic idea, although I'm nervous. Because you know, I don't like to talk a lot, Bishop, with other people. But nonetheless, I do appreciate you bringing this to the forefront to get to know ELC leaders. So thank you for that. Yeah. So let me say a little bit about me and my job. I'm going to try to be as short as I possibly can, because you know it takes me a long time to land a plane, Bishop. But nonetheless,
land the day.
No, I'll land the plane. So at my current everyday life, I am actually a compliance auditor. Okay. That's not what I went to school for. I went to school for computer science.
Wow.
And that was back in the Xerox days, where African-American women were not computer scientists back then. So going to Xerox, I was making copies. I wasn't doing any type of programming. I was getting coffee. And I was like, you know what? This is not for me. This is definitely not for me. So I went into the healthcare.
Okay.
So while I was in the healthcare, I remained in the healthcare pretty much. I've been in it for about 35 years. I'm dating myself because I'm only 36. That's right. So in the healthcare field, I'm actually a compliance auditor. And what that entails, I'm actually director of the compliance team.
Oh, wow.
And so what that entails is, for the most part, make a long story short, we audit all of these doctors out here to say who they say they are. We want to ensure that they got their MD, they did their residency, their internship, they have all the licenses, all the board certifications, they're accredited. Everything that they say they are, my team goes out and ensure that that's who they say they are. And we also, on the other side of auditing, where it's compliance, to make sure they remain compliant.
Yes.
Make sure they keep up their DEA registrations, their licenses, their board certification. So that's what I do as a living in my day-to-day life. And on top of that, my entire team, probably, I would say I'm on the legal and compliance team department. So everyone on that team knows I am a deacon. Everyone on the team knows that I go to church.
Hey.
Everyone knows on the team, don't ask me to do anything on Sundays.
I love it.
Because that is my day that I dedicate to God. You know, so I tell them all about it. They donate when I ask to give for our church anniversaries and so on. So is nothing that my job doesn't know when it comes to who I worship. So they all know that as well.
Well, that is wonderful. First of all, I'm glad that you made it clear to them, because a lot of folks don't. And so I always tell people it's important to let people know, your employer, that, you know, you are a worshiper, you are a person who serves in the church, and it's important to honor your commitment to the church. So I'm so glad that you did that. But more so than that, I'm glad that y'all are catching these folks who ain't really a doctor out here, got a sign and a shingle out, and they working on people, killing people.
That's right. That's right. Absolutely.
But it's glad to know, I'm glad to know, and it's good to know that there's somebody who is checking these people's records and checking out what they're submitting, because so many people slide through the crack. And then oftentimes you go thinking that this is a legitimate doctor. He has earned, or she has earned and studied and done what they're supposed to do, passed exams and all of that. And they ain't passed nothing. They was cheating off of somebody, looking on somebody's paper and printing something out off the internet. Y'all know people print stuff out off the internet,
right? Yes, they
do.
Yes, they
do. I'm so glad that you and your team are doing that. That is fabulous. Fabulous.
Yeah, and believe it or not, Bishop, there are people that actually do it that we have caught. So it's amazing when that happens. It's like, that's not what you said you did. This is not the school you went to, you know? So it's amazing when it pops up. It's very few in between.
Yes.
But, you know, when that happens, it's amazing. And in addition to that, if there are any malpractice cases, we get to know that, like if not killed, but if there were deaths or so on and so forth, we take them out of our network because of the malpractice or, you know, things like that, those type of cases. But it is amazing that there are some providers or doctors out there that are not who they say they are.
Check with your doctor, check all the information, y'all, to make sure that they're who they say that they are.
That's right. So well, now, Deacon Ron, me, I'll tell them.
Oh, and look, check in with Deacon Ron. Don't y'all overload her inbox.
That's right. Don't do it.
Check in with her to see if your doctor's legit, okay? Now, Deacon Ronnie, we know that, you know, sometimes you need to take some time away from verifying all of these doctors and these medical providers and all of that. So what is your favorite pastime? What do you like to do? What do you enjoy doing? What makes you giggle? What makes you smile? Tell us a little bit about that.
Okay, so Bishop, I have a lot of favorite pastimes. I think my number one, which a lot of people don't know, I love working with my hands. Like I like refurbishing furniture. I like to strip it down. I like to turn it into something that looked like it came right off of the floor in the model home or something like that.
Nice.
So I love to refurbish furniture. I love to take things apart and put things together. Let me give you a prime example. So I'm probably putting my mom out there, but my mom has guns, right? She has little guns.
That's all right. The mother can have guns.
That's right. The mother has guns. And when I was younger, when I realized that I liked to tinker, I went in and took her gun apart.
Okay.
And I knew that the gun had bullets. So me watching, I took all the bullets out the chamber and so on. And I took her gun apart.
Okay.
And then, of course, I got in trouble for it, and she had to throw it in the trash. But
you mean you couldn't put it back together?
I put it back together. It was perfect. But you know, me being the good kid that I was, I told her that, you know, hey, Ma, I took your gun apart, and I put it back together. And she was like, "What is wrong with you? Why would you take my gun apart?"
Right.
So anyway, needless to say, she did get rid of it because she said I may not have put a right spring in place or whatever the case may be. So she got rid of it. So she said, well, why don't you just, you know, take the telephone apart, something that can't really hurt you. So I took the telephone apart.
Oh, wow.
And this was over my aunt's house. I took the telephone apart, and for whatever reason, there's a little magnetic piece inside of the receiver of the telephone that I couldn't quite manage to get underneath where it was supposed to go. So my uncle came home, used the phone, and they couldn't hear him. And so I got in trouble because I didn't put the phone together correctly. So that's one of my favorite pastimes is to take things apart, put them together. I love refurbishing furniture or, you know, whatever it is, I like to refurbish it.
I love that because I'm a big watcher of the flea market flip. Oh, and I've been
Bishop,
saying,
that's my favorite.
look, I love that. So I've been saying we need to do a flea market flip
That's a
here.
good
And
idea.
so I think we have enough people now who like to do those types of things that we're going to do that. And so we're going to challenge another church to, flip against ELC flippers,
That's
okay?
good. I
And
love that
so,
show.
yes, I love flea market flip. And so it sounds like you would be an ideal candidate to go on there and get your $5,000.
That's right. Give my coins.
Get your coins, get
Give
your
my
coins.
coins.
And so now, in enjoying the refurbishing, sometimes there's things that you like to wear that helps you to feel a little bit more comfortable. So now, what would be your favorite type of clothes? Do you like to wear hats? Do you like to wear socks your thing? Is shoes your thing? You got a whole closet of shoes. You like jeans, t-shirts. What is it that you like to do? We know you have a business. I'll get to that in a few. But what is it that you like to wear that makes you feel very comfortable?
So what makes me feel comfortable, believe it or not, I love button-down shirts.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And so I can put on a button-down shirt with anything, with sweatpants, with shorts, with well, I won't go there, but I love button-down shirts. Button-down shirts and flip-flops.
Yeah, I've seen you with those.
Yes, that is my favorite. I can wear flip-flops in the spring, summer, winter, and fall, and shorts with a button-down shirt. That is my go-to most comfortable clothing that I like to wear. I'm
Wow.
not a big tennis shoe person. I like tennis shoes, but I'm more of a hard bottom shoe person, more
Okay.
so than tennis shoes. I like them, but that's not my forte. I like hard bottom shoes, but my go-to comfortable items of clothing will be a button-down shirt, cut-off jean shorts, and flip-flops.
All right. And so most of us who know we've seen you in that attire. And so if you had to say your favorite color, most people have a color that attracts them, a color that kind of does something for them and makes you feel a certain way. What is your favorite color? What's the deacon's favorite color?
So my favorite color is orange.
Orange.
Yes, orange that you have on.
Yes.
It makes me happy. And I did some research on the color of orange,
Okay.
believe it or not. And if you think about it, orange is appealing to us as individuals, to our taste buds. So candy bars, Reese's peanut butter cups, Reese's Pieces, Kit Kat, all those things are wrapped in orange because it's
Yes, they
supposed to
are.
be so appealing to
Yeah.
the eye and it makes you happy and so on. So orange is my go-to color. I love it.
All right. So anybody who wants to send Deacon Ronnie anything, make sure it's orange, okay? Your chances of her sending it back will be very low.
Absolutely. No matter what it is, orange clothes, orange candy, orange slippers, socks, whatever, orange button-down shirts, I'll take
Orange button-down
that
shirts.
too.
Yes. So we got that. We got that. So now, when you look at, sometimes there are things that we like to do. We like to use our passion, use our gifts, and do that on the side of the people who employ us. And so, are you an entrepreneur? If so, tell us about your business. What's the name of your business, and how can people find you?
Sure. So yes, I am an entrepreneur. I think I've been that since I was about 10 years old.
Okay.
Going door to door to sell whatever I can sell. Putting something together and selling it. I used to sell slingshots. I did all the things. But I've been a professional entrepreneur for about 5 years. The name of my company is Fella by Ronnie, and I think my audience is a masculine energy. So whether you're a male or a male that loves male clothes, or if you're a female that likes male's clothing, you look good in them like myself. I feel very comfortable in male's clothing, and I actually cater to the male energy is what I want to call it. And with that being said, my company actually started by me making bow ties for whomever, anyone who wanted bow ties. I started making bow ties. And how I got started making the bow ties, my brother, Joseph Bullock, he needed a television.
Okay.
And just so happened I had an extra television laying around, and I said, well, what are you gonna give me for this television? And so he said, well, I have a sewing machine. And I said, what am I gonna do with a sewing machine? So he said, I don't know, but we want
Lord.
to barter. So I gave him my flat screen television and he gave me a sewing machine.
That was a
And
good deal.
That was a good deal. And so I sat down and I said, what am I going to do with this sewing machine? And that's when I started coming into myself saying that I love bow ties. Yes. So let me just go ahead and sit down and make myself a bow tie. Well, it took me about 10 hours to make one bow tie. As a matter of fact, I still have it. And that's what started me with Fella, by starting off making bow ties. So I've gone into making bow ties, to dressing, to styling, to coordinating, to doing all sorts of things with the male energy population.
Okay.
You can find me on Facebook at Fella by Ronnie, Instagram, Fella by Ronnie, that's P-H-E-L-L-A by Ronnie, Instagram, Facebook. I have a website, Fella by Ronnie. So just about any social network, you can find me on Fella by Ronnie, and I'll be happy to provide you the services that I offer.
Wow, that's great. And you know, we've had the wonderful privilege of having some of your bow ties 1 year for Praying in Pink, and you know, for other events. And so now you are into styling. And I know there are lots of people who are getting married or have special events, special occasions, whether it's anniversaries and all those things. And so you're able to style them, help them to get the look that they want, and help them to know what to stay away from.
That's right.
Not to wear. Okay.
And it's important. And it's important. It depends on your body. So everybody can't wear everything. Just because you see it and it looks good, it may not necessarily look good on you. And I'm going to tell you the truth. You know, if you have a short neck, you probably don't need to wear a bow tie. You probably may need to wear an ascot or a necktie, or maybe not even a tie at all. You know, we can you can still be dressy without a necktie or bow tie on it. You know, so a lot of people, you know, don't quite get it and say, you know, I look sloppy in this. What's wrong? So, you know, I teach you the proper etiquette in how to put your suit on, how to put your shirts on. You know, make sure your pant leg is not too long, it's not dragging on the floor, and things like that, as well as etiquette, because sometimes when people go out on dates, they don't know to use the furthest fork out to your left as possible when you start. Yeah. So I teach those things at all. And it's, and you know, you shouldn't be feel bad about it, but some people just don't know. So I love Emily Post. She is one of the etiquette people of the world. Well, she used to be, she's no longer living, but I go by her etiquette as well. So I teach those things also when I do weddings, because sometimes they say, well, what should I do this time? Or what should I do this time? Because I truly believe that chivalry isn't dead for those masculine energy individuals. I believe in open, and this comes with my package. So I'm not just talking, but this comes with my package.
Absolutely.
You know, like open the door for your spouse, or, you know, pull the seat out. If you're that person and you want to be able to, tell your significant other, let me show you how I can take care of you. So we go into those etiquettes as well when we go, especially when we do weddings, we talk a lot about that. And that comes with my package.
And that's great. Great to know, because so many people as children were not taught those etiquette rules about what to fork to use with the salad and, you know, what's your dessert, silverware. And so, yes, a lot of people do need to know those things. And it's important, because I have seen some folks with some jackets that they did not need to wear.
That's right.
I've seen some folks where it was hanging off. It was looking kind of bad. And it was not for me to tell them, because I didn't even know them. But I just saw them in passing. And so, people sometimes need to be honest.
They don't know. They don't know. So if they don't know, they don't know. And, you know, Fella is here to tell you. And then once you know, you got it. It's gravy.
Yes, yes, yes. And so thank you. And I can say to my deacon and armor bearer that I have seen some sleek looking outfits, and I really did want to wear them. And I tried on the jacket. It wasn't even close.
That's right, Bishop. Don't wear it.
I said, okay, that wasn't for me.
That's right.
So again, when you start getting them in bigger sizes, it don't even look the same.
You're like, it doesn't. It doesn't. It looks good on that hanger, but don't put it on.
No. It doesn't even look the same. You don't even have the same feeling. So you let me go get something else.
That's right. Exactly. Okay.
And so now, oftentimes, those people who are in the church and serving in the church today have had some type of church experience growing up. So tell us a little bit about your church experience growing up, and then tell us about your church experience today, and if you enjoy your church experience today, where you are.
Sure. Okay. So I was born and raised Pentecostal my entire life. From the time I can remember, I am what they call one of those church kids, church babies, because I love church. So I grew up in Pentecostal where everything was wrong, almost breathing was wrong. So, you know, don't breathe like that.
Right. The devil, that's the devil.
That's right. The devil's in that kind of breathing. So, I grew up in a family that were ministers and pastors and bishops and, you know, so on and so forth. And I was not quite sure why I loved church, but I didn't quite get that I didn't belong necessarily because something was kind of off. You know, I sang in a choir. Of course, I played the drums and under, you know, my skirt, I had on some shorts because, you know, I was feeling some kind of way or whatever. And we were just, you know, taught that being gay, you're going to go to hell.
Yes.
Being different, being loving women or loving the same sex, you're going to die and you're going to go to hell. And that's how I grew up.
Yes.
And of course, being a church kid, listening to your pastor, of course, I'm like, well, I can't do that because I'm going to die and go to hell.
Right.
So, you know, I thought that for a very long time, and I was in and out to church because I love church so much, but I hated every time when they would get to that point where they would say you're going to die and go to hell. It just cringed me and I couldn't take it. So, but when I would leave church, I would miss church. I would come back and I would be like, oh, why did I come back? Then, you know, it was back and forth
until
finally, years, I would say maybe 5 or 6 years ago, this, that recent, I finally said, you know, I love my church. I love my family dearly. I love my pastors and so on dearly, but this is just not it for me.
Right.
And so I left and I was doing bedside manner and I was searching for churches and, you know, so on and so forth, watching things. And then finally, I was in the bed and I was looking for a church, not knowing what I was looking for, but I was looking for a church to go to.
Yes.
And lo and behold, your face popped up, Bishop Allison Abram, and your story came up. And I was like, and from Michigan, because I used to live in Michigan.
Right.
And Michigan. And I was like, let me check this out. So that following Sunday, I went online. You were live on Facebook. I went online, listened to the service, and I was like, oh, she can preach a little bit. She sound like, you know, back in the day, like, like, you know, sound like she got some Pentecostal or something going on up in there. And I said, let me go and check her out. It was me and Eliana. Let me go and check her out. This was before we even got married. I said, let me go and check this church out. So we went, checked you out. And actually we were late because I remember that we were watching online trying to get there because I don't know why we were late, but nonetheless, we were late. We got there. I think we came to two services. I think on the third service, I was like, this is it for me. We might as well go ahead and join ELC because, you know, some of the things that you were preaching about, like I never knew what affirming was, had no clue. I never knew what being off. Now I knew what authentic meant, but I didn't know what authentic meant in my world.
Yes.
I had no clue that I could come to church with the person that I loved and not be snared at or snarled out and not be told that we were going to go to hell. Yeah. I found out that I can love the person who I'm with.
Yes.
And God can love me as well. And I'm not going to die and go to hell. There are some things that come along with it. Like you still need to do the right thing.
Absolutely.
I'm not saying, you know, I can go out here and be buck wild and just sin and all over the place. Cause there are some prerequisites, you know, that needs to be done, you know, and that's what I got from you. You know, you can be authentic. You can come to church with your significant other and God can still love you because of who you are. God loves you for exactly who you are. And so for that, you know, I am so grateful. I don't mind going to my former church because my family's still there, but it doesn't bother me anymore because of what I've learned from Empowerment Liberation Cathedral under your teachings, is that God can love you for exactly who you are, as long as you're doing what you're supposed to do in the body of Christ.
Absolutely.
So it has been a long journey for me, Bishop. I mean, people don't know it. I've been married to a bishop myself, back in the day, the first lady. all of those good things. But you know, I'm grateful that I went through all of that. And the reason why I say that, because I wouldn't have had a kid and I wouldn't have had grandchildren and so on and so forth, you know, but I'm also so grateful for finding you on the internet and finding ELC. And I never knew that I could hold a position in the church that I worship and my authentic self. Yes. And when, you know, you came to me and said, you know, well, God says, you know, it's come to me that we want you to be a deacon at our church. And I was like, oh my God, this is the best day ever. And not a deaconess, because like you taught us, there's no such thing as deaconess. It's not in the Bible. There's no such thing as deaconess. They are deacons. Yes. And so I was so honored and so grateful to become a deacon at ELC at my church, where I can be affirmed and I can be authentic. So it's been a journey, but I'm grateful that God, through you, told me about ELC. And here we are today, me here and my wife, who is a minister at ELC.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you so much. And we're so glad and honored to have you to serve as a deacon at ELC. But I want to cover a couple of things, because back in the beginning, I talked a lot about authenticity and truth, and living your authenticity and living your truth, because so many people could not live in their authenticity on Sundays. That's they were doing other things throughout the week, but Sunday, hey, no, I got to put on this mask and got to come into the church and be somebody else. And so we talked a lot about that, and we still talk about it today. But that was important, and it still is important that people come in as their authentic selves and they walk back out the same authentic person, but filled with the Holy Ghost and you know, drawn closer to God and experiencing God's love and experiencing God's presence. So we always want that. And then I used to talk a lot about, Deacon, you might remember this, it is a privilege to serve in God's church.
That's
and
right.
There's absolutely no reason why you, in your authenticity, ought not be able to use your gifts
and
honor God with what God has given you. And if God has called you, your orientation shouldn't have anything to do with it.
That's
if God has called you, your gender expression ought not have anything to do with it, because God is not calling your orientation. God is calling the spirit that's in you to serve the people of God and to serve in this time. And so therefore, that's why we have you, we have other deacons and ministers who are serving in their authenticity. And as far as I can see, God has not stopped Deacon Ronnie from shouting on Sunday. God has not stopped Deacon Ronnie from being able to pray on Sundays or whenever she needs to pray.
That's
and
right,
Bishop. So, you know, God is still using you. And so that ought to debunk everybody's thought that if you gay, God ain't with you. God is definitely with the folks at ELC. Now, I can't talk about nobody else, but I know God is with the people at ELC.
But you know what, Bishop? That's funny, because I think I probably even shout more. You know, you heard of Shouting John, right?
Shouting John.
They call me Shouting Ron. So.
Shouting Ron.
But that's so true. Yes.
And so, you know, we're just honored, like I said, to have you to serve as a deacon at the church and to use your gifts. And you've brought so many gifts to the church, and so many people are inspired by so many things that you do.
Thank you.
We're just glad to have you. And also, even though people are now going live, I tell people all the time, ELC always been live.
That's right.
You know, Facebook and all of that. We were on Instagram Live. We were on any platform they had live where we could find people.
That's right.
So that's how so many people were able to find us, because we need our message to go global, and we need people to hear this message, and we need the message of God to resonate with the people, that God loves you just as you are.
Absolutely.
God says, come as you are. God doesn't want you to leave part of you outside the door and you pick it up on the way back home.
That's right.
So You know, we want people to come just as they are to ELC.
That's right. God don't want you to be phony, you know, praising him and pretending and all that. He wants you to come. I mean, I always say, Bishop, you preached not too long ago, my favorite person in the Bible is Rahab.
Yes.
And yes, he was able to use Rahab. I mean, she was the woman of the streets, per se.
Yes.
And he was able to use her. And that I don't know why that resonates with me all the time. Yes. But just like he used Rahab, and I'm not saying these people are Rahabs out here. I'm not saying they're harlots or anything. Right. But I'm just saying that God can definitely use you exactly who you are and your authentic self for his glory. And that's what it is. All about his glory.
Absolutely, absolutely, absolutely. And we're so glad that God is using you in the way that God is using you. And look, folks always know when Deacon Ronnie or Shouting Ron is at church, because you hear the tambourine going.
Right, that's right.
Her shouting, you can see her shouting kind of move across the front of the floor. And so you know it's on when that happens, okay? And so it's a wonderful thing that we can help to liberate those who have heard so many teachings that would make them think that God does not love them. And so that's what we're about. And so Deacon Ronnie, as we come to a close with this interview, get to know us, are there any encouraging words you want to give to those who are at home, working from home in social isolation, practicing social distancing? You know, this COVID-19 is totally changing people's lives, and people are having to do things different. Just like at ELC, we're figuring some things out and how to do some things different. And so what would you say to just encourage somebody that, you know, they can make it? What would you say?
Yeah, so Bishop, you know, it is some tiring times, but I know it's kind of cliche, but I say this too shall pass.
Yes.
You know, and I feel that with everything I am. You know, we've been through a lot in this world. We've been through a lot of diseases. We've been through wars. We've been through 9/11. I mean, we've been through so much. So I think this too shall pass. So that's my encouraging word. However, we still should be cognizant of our surroundings. We still should ensure that we are, if we have to go out, that we absolutely keep that 6 feet distance from from other people.
Yes.
You know, I put on Facebook the other day is, and I was being silly, but when I walk past people, I would hold my breath because I didn't want to ingest anything that they had, but I was just being silly. But nonetheless, I'm just saying, I think we need to do what they are telling us, the authorities are telling us to do, what the doctors are telling us to do. Don't go out if you don't have to go out.
Yes.
I mean, you know, of course, if you run out, you have to get your toilet tissue or whatever those things.
Ain't no more toilet tissue.
I think Eliana bought it all. Just stay home, you know, read a book that you've been wanting to read. Talk with your loved ones that you haven't spoken to a long time, you know, check on them. Find a new hobby or get back invested in your old hobby that you keep saying, you know, I've been wanting to paint for a long time. Now's a good time to, you know, paint. Do some things that is quality time with your family.
Yes.
You know, we've been watching old movies. I love old black and white movies. Love.
Yes.
Cowboy movies is my favorite. My family hates them. But, you know, every now and then I'll make them sit down and watch some of those movies. But stay encouraged. Do what the authorities are telling us to do, not the 145. Don't listen to nothing he's saying.
Don't listen to him.
When I say nothing, I mean nothing. He is clueless. And he is not out for us as people.
No.
It is not about us. I mean, let me not go on that rant, Bishop.
Because you know, we'll be on for 30 more minutes talking about 45.
That's right. That's right. But the doctors, Kumo is doing an excellent job.
Yes, he is.
Listen to the authorities. But, you know, most of all, stay encouraged. You know, people like the world is coming to the end. Nobody knows when the world's coming to an end. So you might as well get that out your head.
Right.
Nobody knows any of those things.
Right.
But, you know, stay encouraged. Spend time with your loved ones, whoever's in your house. Don't go out to their house. Stay home.
Yes.
But, you know, call them on the phone or do some video chatting and, you know, things like that. Do something that you've been wanting to do for a long time.
Absolutely.
And then just pick it up and do it.
Yeah, and video chatting, I think, is good. I've done a lot of Marco Polos, and if I hadn't got to you yet, rest assured I'm getting to you. Okay, but and I check in on the seniors a lot too, because it's important to check in on our senior members of our community, and
That's
so we
right.
want to make sure we're doing that as well.
That's right.
So, Deacon Ronnie, thank you so much for giving us a chance to learn a few things about you that we did not know.
Thank you.
Anybody, want to make sure folks know stuff about Deacon Ronnie, make sure that you share this once we end. And we want to say, may God keep you, may God continue to bless you, bless the work that you do for him, as well as bless all the businesses and everything that you do for others. And I want to say, make sure everybody that you are signing on every day at 4 p.m. We're going to feature some of our other leaders at ELC. I tell you, we've got the best leaders
Yes,
on the
we do.
planet at
Yes, we do.
Empowerment Liberation Cathedral, and they are top-notch, and everybody's praying for you. They want the best for you during this COVID-19, and we were already praying for you before now,
That's
but
right.
we can say
That's
we are
right.
definitely praying for you now. And
That's right.
so once again, you can find Deacon Ronnie with Fella by Ronnie on Facebook. You can find her on Instagram, and you can go to her website. And if you have anything coming up and you know that you don't know how to make yourself look the way you need to look, contact Deacon Ronnie and Fella. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Deacon Ronnie.
Thank you,
And
Bishop.
God bless you and God keep.